Welcome back to the Blitz 16 College Kickoff Preview. Two down, one last Big 3 school to check in with, and we head to the flagship, the University of Mississippi. After two consecutive Cotton Bowl victories, Ole Miss sputtered and stalled under Houston Nutt, a 2-10 season culminating in his dismissal. The Rebels, though, bring back a majority of starters on both sides of the ball. However, they've only had 15 spring practices and the month of August to pick up some new schemes. After last season's heartbreaking opening loss, they need confidence and quick, the Rebels. Their crucial game will be this Saturday against Central Arkansas. Northward we go as we take you inside the Rebel football program.
Whatever the school board says at the end, we can live with as long as we competed.
That's a consistent mantra and expectation out of Hugh Freeze for this year's Rebels. 60 minutes of the right attitude and effort. Easier said than done, however, coming off a 2-10 campaign in 2011. There were some glasses half full moments, though. Ole Miss led for nearly the entire BYU game before a fourth quarter fumble. They were then deadlocked with Auburn after one half of play, and they fell to fifth-ranked Arkansas by only 5. So is it possible things aren't as bleak as they appear?
Our skill set is just as high as any other team in this league.
I sure hope that that is the case and that we'll be maybe a little deeper than I worry that we're not.
People only look at the score sometimes, and you know what I'm saying? But there's a lot of deeper things go into Saturday. We definitely have a strong team. We had a strong team last year. We have to learn how to finish and fight as a team.
There will be a new approach deployed for battle for Ole Miss, a multiple look 4-2-5 defense, which will disguise coverages and pressures better than last year's 4-3 formation. But it's the offense that needs the jump start, and Freeze thinks he has the antidote.
With the weapons we have, you know, the fast guys like Jeff Scott and the receivers that we have, you know, being fast out on the field definitely is an advantage for us.
I just think that it's so much different than anything that anybody's seen in the SEC. It's so fast.
I just think it limits what a defense can do and the package they can carry into a game if you're able to go consistent time frames at a very high up-tempo rate.
New staff, new attitude, but the same goals. The team is squarely focused on their September 1st season opener, but they know their last game in November is when they'll need to shine.
Being here, I know how Ole Miss fans feel about the Egg Bowl, and us not having it for 3 years, you know, really upsets us. And I hear Mississippi State fans talk about it all the time. So, you know, we plan on getting that back this year and keeping it for a while.
I have been here since I've been here, and I almost went there. So, you know, it's a big chip on my shoulder.
You know, I've said all along, I give credit where credit's due. They've captured the momentum the last few years, and that's one of the reasons I'm here, I'm sure, and I understand the rivalry and anticipate us starting to regain it hopefully this year.
All right, now, quick history lesson, guys. Ole Miss makes BYU go 3-and-out last year, first game of the year. BYU shanks the punt. Ole Miss gets the ball on the 28-yard line of BYU. Jeff Scott runs 8 yards, fumbles the ball, the wheels come off the whole thing. Are they as bad as the 2-and-10 record suggested, Coach Williams?
It couldn't have happened to a better group of guys.
Oh, come on. You can't talk like that. I mean, like, we've got too many MSU guys up here. But, I mean, honestly, I mean, they've got the talent across the board to muster up more than 2 wins.
Well, I think the recruiting of Coach Nutt and the lack of depth they had really led. Once you get into an SEC grind and guys start getting hurt, banged around, they just didn't have guys that they could put in with a talent level to keep up. For example, LSU kneeling the ball, Alabama wearing them out. It's just once you get into that grind, you got to have some bodies just to hold up, and they didn't. They were too thin.
We'll go to Coach Gray. We'll skip over you, Coach. I don't know if any more Bulldog propaganda for people to get angry at us back. But basically, I mean, Hugh Freeze, he's a real energetic guy. He's got a master plan in place, and he's got this whole spread offense, you know, basketball on grass. I mean, do you think the new energy from a coach can make an instant impact before he gets the talent in there?
Well, the biggest thing for Ole Miss right now is just take it 1 week at a time and just try to stay positive and get a lot of good quality reps day in and day out and just play consistent football, and I think they'll be fine.